Oh, Thank you. Yeah. Seas are chosen a good portion. I have chosen what is better, what will never be taken away. I have chosen you, God. I have chosen you, God. So put me anywhere. Just put your glory in me, and I'll serve anywhere. Just let me see your beauty.
Jesus. May the nation acknowledge you in all her ways. We pray for those in government, in business, education, arts and media mountains to seek your wisdom. The plans of man will fail us and so many, so may your plans speak loud and be what make the straight paths of the U.S. May great delight and desire stir up to see you work in miraculous ways. Make your ways known and seen in the land. Let's pray. Lord, you love America. There is not one who you turn your eyes from. You have poured out your love over America. It is a blessed land, and as America begins to recognize their blessings once again, may hearts turn and be positioned to receive the fullness of your love. May the nation be fully satisfied in you. Quicken hearts to surrender worldly pleasures that do not satisfy, to surrender our short-lived pleasures, to turn from rebellious ways, and to take what is true. Your true love, the fullness of your blessings as our inheritance, and to be sons that reflect the Father's heart. Let's pray. As you search, Lord, near and far, you are finding and setting apart those who will call to stand in the gap. We pray for those with clean hands and a pure heart to be as bold as lions and as quick as gazelles, to lift their heads and shout for joy. May there be a strengthening of the church even as the spiritual warfare becomes greater. May the church withstand every fiery furnace and continue in their building as Nehemiah did. You have prepared the house of God to withstand and overcome the evil one. With authority and anointing, we move forward towards the victory that has been promised to us. Let's pray.
People of prayer, people that will live their lives. Clothe your church with intercession. 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 Clothe your church with intercession.
Anointed one.
Clothe your church with intercession. Clothe your church with intercession. Clothe your church with intercession. Clothe your church with intercession.
Fill them, Holy Spirit.
Clothe your church with intercession. It's time to rise up. 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 It's time to rise up.
Take your time to rise.
Oh, church, it's time to rise up. 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 It's time to rise up, oh church. It's time to rise up. 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 It's time to rise up, oh church. It's time to rise up.
You have called the church to intercession, to raise up a generation of intercessors, Lord, that are on their knees. We pray, Lord God, that no weapon formed against us as intercessors will prevail, and that no weapon formed against America will prevail. We declare, Lord God, that you have paid a heavy price, and Father, we do not take that lightly. But we declare, Lord God, that with this heavy price, Lord God, that you would awaken us, Lord, that you would open up our hearts, Lord God, our hardened hearts, that you would allow America to hear your voice, the voice of the shepherd, and Father, that they would, their eyes would be set on their beloved. We declare, Lord God, that you are America's great reward, that you are what America desires, and you are their destiny, Lord. We pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
King Jesus, you're the name we're lifting high, your glory shaking up the earth and skies, revival. We want to see your kingdom here. We want to see your kingdom here. King Jesus, you're the name we're lifting high. Your glory shaking up the earth and skies. Revival. We want to see your kingdom here. See your kingdom here, Spirit, break out, break our walls down, Spirit, break out, heaven come down. With praise, can you hear? without your touch, we cannot break out of our pride. We cannot break out of our self-sufficiency. We cannot break out of our stubbornness, Lord God, unless you touch us. We cannot escape the inevitable hardness of heart. So we thank you, God, for your faithfulness in constantly softening our hearts to the sound of your voice. Constantly softening our hearts, Lord God, to want and desire more of your presence. We thank you, God, that what you've done in our lives, Lord God, you're able to do in a nation. We thank you, God, that it's your Holy Spirit that can break down every wall. It's your Holy Spirit that can do what seems impossible at times, that can turn a tide, Lord God, that can change the destiny of a nation. We thank you, God, that it's only through your Holy Spirit that this is possible. Lord God, we call out to you. We ask in the name of Jesus that you would do your mighty work of repentance, of forgiveness, of softening of hearts. We thank you, God, that this is only possible through you and in you. We thank you, God, for all you are doing at this hour. We pray, God, that you continue to give us a sense of urgency as a church to rise up as intercessors, as people that are willing to stand in the gap and to pray for the things that are on your heart. We thank you, God, for what you are doing. We know, God, that you are on the move, that you're not a God who just sits back and waits for things to happen, but you're a God who moves on behalf of those who call upon your name. You're a God who acts on behalf of those who call upon you, God. We thank you, God, that at this hour, you are raising up a church that is learning to pray, a church that is learning to intercede, that is learning the power of prayer and the power of your Holy Spirit. We thank you, God. We pray these things in your name. Amen. Amen. Thank you guys for joining us tonight. This month we were supposed to be praying for North Korea on Tuesday nights, but with recent developments of what's been happening, especially in regards to America, we decided to set apart this Tuesday nights to pray for America. And as we press into all the things that are happening, I want us as a church to not make this just a political issue, to not make this just a secular thing that's just based on news and articles, but this is a lot of the things that are happening right now are things that God is very much involved in, and God has a very strong opinion about. And we as a church, as people that are called to be awake, be on watch, and be found praying, we want to be people that are discerning the heart of God, discerning what he wants us to pray and contend for, and really be able to partner with him at this really crucial hour. So I hope that this will be a blessing to you to be able to do that here on Tuesday nights. On Wednesday mornings, we will continue to pray on behalf of Israel. So this entire month, we'll be praying on Tuesday nights for America and then on Wednesdays for Israel. So I hope that you can join us for either one. Unfortunately, next week, Tuesday and Wednesday, we will not be having K1 watches. K1 will be closed next week due to a staff outing. So the entire, all of New Philly, the headquarters, will be closed next week. So we encourage you to continue to pray in your own time, in your own prayer closet, and then to join us in 2 weeks. And if you have nothing better to do and you're on vacation, come out tomorrow morning and pray and worship with us again. So we'll see you guys in 2 weeks, if not tomorrow. Have a wonderful night.